Kovalchuk is playing against Nana Zagnitze. The game has begun with e4, c5, knight f3, d6. The Sicilian defense, a closed variation here with bishop b5 check. Very, very rare variation is what I've seen with bishop a4. I've never seen this Sagar Shah before. Knight f6 has come. Cass is giving up this pawn. But if you take this pawn, then Sagar Bhai, an issue is that after rook e1, white gets a lot of tempo. So that's why they didn't take it, but they played a6, preparing b5 and c4, threatening to trap this bishop, which is why c4 has been played to prevent b5 ideas. So here g6 ke baad khela hai knight c3, developing more pieces. Bishop g7 ke baad khela hai d3, castles ke baad h3, and a very, very safe position, very, very solid position for both the players.
B4 has been played on that board, and the point of Muzichuk is that I want to create some play down the b file with my rook. Now the knight on c3 is undefended, but there is no easy way to attack it. You can go knight g4, hg4, bishop c3, but okay, you didn't gain much. Also remember the fact that Anna Muzichuk is on 3 out of 3 and is clearly been the main strength of Ruthless Rook's performance in this tournament. Yeah, bishop c3, and then maybe b takes c5. I was thinking that you could just play, or maybe you could just do a3, Samai, instead of taking on c5, a3, and white seems to be doing fine. Although Nana Zagnitze's position looks very nice, you know, she's played e6, and you will see that she has all her pieces nicely positioned. It's a very strategic battle. Matlab, black is trying to build up a fortress, white is trying to attack. You know, it's just an interesting position. G5 looks like a nice move, right?
G5, I mean, of course, attacking the bishop, asking the bishop to go back.
Anna Zagnitze has started playing on the king side with her knights and the pawns. Look at that. She's just managed to get all the pieces there, and the knights are there. It seems as if Nana has a clear practical advantage in the position.
Bilkul. Big true. Result coming in here. Wow.
Suddenly,
kya hua? Nana ji was doing fine. Suddenly, what happened?
B8, she took with the queen, which was unnecessary. She should have taken with the rook on B8 on move number 26. When rook takes B8 was played, she should have taken with the rook here. She took with the queen,
and this allowed
the c5 pawn, and she thought, I'll get back the d3 pawn, attacking the knight on f3. But I think what she missed was that rook b1, and her queen has very few squares to go to.
So she
went queen d6 in the position, and she thought, okay, let's at least exchange. But queen a7 check came in.
Bishop e8 threatening mate in one with queen f7.
Yeah. Knight e7.
And giving up a piece, an entire piece.
Yeah, she's piece up, but c3 is hanging, Samai. Rook takes c3 could be possible, but then a8 is also hanging in the position. So, in a way, Anna Muzichuk once again coming through for the team of Ruthless Rooks.
Here, Anna Muzichuk has won by resignation.
Yeah.
And that is a great result for the Ruthless Rooks.
Hello, Anna. How are you?
Hello, I am fine. Thanks.
Anna, your team today lost their match. At some point, we thought that Ruthless Rooks might win today, especially with, you know, how the situation was. But you have been playing phenomenal chess. You have scored 4 victories out of 4 games. Tell us a bit about how are you feeling, and how was your game today?
Well, it's always nice to win. Can't complain about that. But unfortunately, the team lost. I feel a bit sorry that it didn't help, let's say, in our last match. And it's quite nervous because before this round, I think we were leading, and after losing this match, we are basically on the verge of not qualifying to the top 4. So with every day, it's very unpredictable, and many things may change just in one round.